The whole world right now is wondering about the matter of black lives. So I've taken the American flag and turned it upside down. And the United States federal flag code says that when we the people perceive that the nation is in distress of life and property and freedom, that on behalf of the men and women who gave their life under the colors of this flag for our freedom, that we're to take the flag and turn it upside down as a signal to ourselves tonight to organize, to eradicate the reasons for why our lives are under stress, life and property and freedom. And so from this hill, we're calling upon the President of the United States to turn the flag over the White House upside down and to issue an executive order that every federal building in America, every military base, every sea-going, ocean-going, lake, river-going vessel turn their flag upside down, and every embassy around the world of America and consulate, in order to remind people, all the people that have marched for the matter of black lives, to not forget. Because too often, we'll blow up, have demonstrations about a racial incident, and we go back to our corners and it happens again. We forget. That's human nature, not a critique, just an observation. But with the flag flying every day in our country upside down, that reminds people, oh yeah, the matters of black lives. We must resolve this matter so we can turn that flag. And I'm really hoping, I believe the president will do it. So Martin Luther King said that if we have racial incidents and we blow everything up and then go back to business as usual, one day America will have a rude awakening. And I believe that this is the rude awakening that he prophesied about. And he said that America shall have neither rest nor tranquility until the Negro, black people, black lives, receives their full experiential citizenship as is enjoyed by white citizens. And he said that the whirlwinds of revolt will continue to shake the foundations of the nation until that bright day of justice arrives. And I believe that it is my responsibility at this time to begin that fulfillment of the prophecy. That's why I'm here, you know? I mean, some people think that I'm being an anarchist, that I'm anti-American, but you know from meeting me before in my person of Mr. Patriot that is not so. I love my country, and I want my country, as the Constitution says, we the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union to establish justice. That is my and our responsibility. That is not the job of the president, the mayors, the governors, the elected people. That is the job of we the people. And the only reason why, at least in this country, that our government personnel has become intoxicated with power and doing idiotic things is because we the people have not supervised them. And as you know, I tell people here, you can't call our government servants idiots when we're supposed to supervise them. You don't hire a person and not supervise them. If you do hire a person and you don't supervise them and they mess up your establishment, you have no one to blame but yourself. So I tell the American people, while we march against the police, we march against the government, actually, we need to march against ourselves because we have failed ourselves. Subsequently, we have failed our government servants. They need to be supervised. I am hoping, my intent, to create a revolution of the mind, the way we think. If we can think right, you get the head right, everything else follows its natural order. Seek first the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added to you. It's that kind of a principle. So that's where I'm at.